Major challenge was, how are we going to do this? We quickly had to decide how to do the aging. You know, are we going to use different actresses? Are we going to go all CG and not have anything?
So we got into these very specific charts of what would look in a human like 4 months old, then 6 months old, then 2, 3, 4 years, 5, 6, 7, 8.
What Bill didn't want to do is just cast a baby, a 1.5, a 2, and have it just be a different person going up until it's Mackenzie, which is how you would normally film it. He wanted to be able to see Mackenzie all the way back down into the stage of a baby. The company employed to do this is Lola, and Lola's famous for doing this type of work, the Benjamin Button and Social Network and Captain America. But even so, this is something still a hybrid of their techniques, and it's something very different.
You know, we worked with Edson and Lola on the first movie, making Bella look emaciated and that whole progression, which I thought was incredibly difficult. But it was exponentially harder what they were taking on here.
All the work was based on Mackenzie's features. Fortunately, her parents took a lot of photos. So we have, you know, great reference photos of her as a baby. We have great reference photos of her as 2-year-old, a 4-year-old, a 6-year-old. And it's really, she's had a well-documented childhood, which really makes our job a lot easier.
Someone was saying the other day, she never went through an awkward phase, you know. I mean, this girl was just beautiful from the day she was born, you know. But so they're incredibly helpful to capture, you know, what she was like at each stage.
There's multiple steps to her anatomy. The first is the newborn. So she's just a few days old. We finally get to see the whole family interacting as a unit, which is great. Two things you don't shoot is pets and children. And we literally were shooting a baby, trying to get to performances. So it was problematic because on set, you only get so many minutes with a child. You can't do a 12-hour day with a newborn. So it was constantly rotating through different babies. You'd get the baby for a few takes, and all of a sudden it'd be magically a different baby for a few takes. So it was an interesting process.
You're asleep. Go to sleep.
I have to say, it was amazing to watch Rob with the babies. You know, he would just turn into this completely different person. He just loved being around kids. And he would actually argue, you know, it's like, why do I have to keep giving the baby away to other people? You know, it's like, I don't get to hold her enough, or I don't get to be with her enough. He really seemed to love playing off of children.
And then once we had the initial baby footage, then coming back to the post side, it's also challenging because they don't perform, you know, to the camera. They just kind of, they'll flop around a little bit. So we'd realign the posture of the baby to be more self-aware. Once we did that, and we started putting the Mackenzie Foy baby onto this, and then that's really where it started to come alive. The next step in that process was the eye line. Now, we're doing CG eyeballs because obviously a baby, you can't say, look to the right, look to the left. A baby just does what it wants. So then we started controlling the eye line with digital eyeballs. We have little CG eyeballs that we can control. You look at Bella, look down, look at Bella, look at the piano, whatever it had to be. It's a lot of steps. Every shot's 5 seconds, months and months and months in work, just for this little cute baby, months in work, just for this little cute baby. The next stage is now she's about 4 years old. She's talking, and this is where we started using the actual Mackenzie Foy footage.
We cast girls who would basically play the body of Renesmee, and then we would put her face in.
As soon as she says, what are you doing to her, then you put your hand down and start looking at her too.
So the process is multi-phase. You have a body double, like a 4-year-old girl running around on set, you know, interacting with everyone on set. What's the wrong face? It's just a body double. So once we have that, we take Mackenzie Foy, we bring her into what we call the light stage.
I would sit in this chair with cameras and lights all around me. And I'd have Phil stand to keep my head still, and I'd keep my health steady just like that. And then I would talk and make facial emotions.
I look up here, and then look right in the middle of the camera. It's a photographic rig surrounded by lights, and the lights will change to anything we want. So Mackenzie will sit in a chair, much like this, stare at a camera, and deliver her performance as the lights change around her. We'll take this footage of Mackenzie, and we'll de-age her. You know, we bring in some fat to her face, make her nose smaller, flatten the bridge of her nose, make her teeth, younger teeth, reduce any eye bags. We really just take Mackenzie as 11-year-old, make her look 4, and stick that onto the body double. One thing we're discovering as we work through this process, the older Renesmee in the movie gets, the easier our job is. We're doing less and less deformations. You're able to keep more of the original Mackenzie Foy. It starts to look more like her.
Hey, Mark. Hey, Mark.
And then the movie ends with Mackenzie as an 18-year-old. And that was also very challenging because how does a person change as they get older? What features change? Your ears get bigger, your nose gets longer, and you get a little bit deeper eye bags, your brow gets wider. And we followed those guidelines to determine how she will age. You know, it's going to be interesting in 7 years from now. I think I'll rent the movie and, you know, look and say, ooh, you know, either we're going to be really close or be way off. But we did do our forensic best guess.